God Almighty, I beseech thee, heed our plea. Accept into your divine grace the tormented prayers of these your worshipful servants. Can you not feel it, children? God's presence.
Perhaps they are possessed!
Yes! Perhaps the devil orders them not to speak!
No. These innocents are afflicted. They are not possessed.
What affliction?
Get away! Get away! Get off my eating!
Ye are in a house of God. Be not afraid. What afflicts you?
A witch! A witch! A witch! A witch! A witch!
Where be this witch, child? What see you, child?
There is a witch!
Children, you have no choice! Father.
You should be in bed, all of you. It's down in the village. The wall caught fire.
Oh, heaven protect them. Are you going?
Not even if it was across the road.
That isn't Christian, Father.
Lizzie, my father did not ask thee to speak. Go on to bed.
It's not with God's teaching.
Lizzie, let me explain. The Walcotts are kin to Thomas Putnam. He will soon have me in flames as welcome my help in extinguishing them.
But why? They are Puritans like us.
These are complicated times, child.
Feast and famine as one body.
Samuel, there is a fire. Might it be Indians?
Protect the children, Elizabeth.
Lord, I have fear of this night. Put your hand on me. Put your hand on me.
We need fire up there! Fire! Get the fight! Get more water! And then we'll join the line! There's more goats in there! Quick, rebuild that door! Get them out! Get the dirt! Join the line over there! Find the shaft!
Come on now, push! Push, that's it.
No more.
No, come on, Goody Putnam. Push for the new baby.
If it's Indians, they'll kill everybody. Isn't so, Mercy. My father's there.
His father gonna be killed by Indians?
They killed my father. And my mother. And the children. Indians kill everybody. One by one.
Annie, it's time. What are you standing around for, useless things? Maid, wash these clothes. Annie, don't just stand there staring, child. You're about to learn how to bring a baby into the world. Nathaniel, you stay there. Annie, fetch another candle.
Harder. That's it. Come on now, Goody Putnam, push for the new baby.
I can't. Oh, why is this taking so long?
Get me in closer, child. I can't see my own hands in the shadows.
Is she dying?
Bring the candle closer. For God's sake, help me, child.
Big boy, Goody Putnam.
here.
You must not despair, Jonathan. We'll have your new barn in no time.
But what if May was right about the Indians? This was not the work of Indians. I believe it was a devil's specter did this.
Witchcraft?
Aye.
I'd be a good Christian. Why would I be plagued by witchcraft?
Thomas Putnam! Goodman Putnam. You're needed at home. The baby was born still. Never took a breath, poor thing.
Was it a son?
Goodman Putnam, the child. He is not alive. Shall I tell your wife you are returning?
May our Lord be with you, Thomas.
He'll be along.
What if Goodman Tarble was right about the specters? And now this is a dark force with us.
Annie? Yes, Mama?
Bring him to me. I want to hold him.
No. No, Mama, I don't want to.
You tempt Satan, you disobey. Bring him.
My home holds another son that has died. It is a grief I've known before, yet the pain of it still cuts as sharp as the first. You know this. You have all lost children.
Aye. And we'll all share your sorrow.
Aye, Thomas.
God bless.
God bless you.
And Goody Putnam, Thomas.
Which is why I have come here, to appeal to you. Neighbor to neighbor, Puritan to Puritan. On a single night, our village has lost a barn to fire and a child's life. Forces of darkness are upon our village. Our village. I'm asking for your support of our minister,
Our minister. Half the village worships in town as they always have.
And it's time that we split from the town.
Split from the town?
They no longer serve the village's interests.
The village's interests? Don't you mean the Putnam's interests?
It was the Putnams who brought Reverend Paris to the village and gave him land under the meeting house. That was village land that was not yours to give away.
The village committee voted it.
Your village committee, made up of all your brothers.
This is the stubbornness that has driven away our last two ministers.
It is your stubbornness that brought in the third. You had no right to give away that land.
If indeed dark forces have descended upon Salem Village, what will happen if we are not united to meet them?
I want to walk with my mother.
Shh! Hush thy noise. 'Tis thy baby brother we're burying.
Joseph Putnam has his eye on thee.
Bite your tongue, May.
Pray he does not trip walking backwards like that.
Shh! Elizabeth.
Bring these biscuits to the children outside, Tituba.
Yes, Mum.
Dear Anne, have you taken food?
No, I've no need for it.
And prayer? Surely the need for that has not left you. God is waiting to hear you. Isn't he, Reverend Paris?
He awaits us all, good in us.
Come. Show your faith, Anne Putnam.
Almighty God.
Israel Porter cares less about his faith than making money in Salem town.
He and John Proft are both.
They're even discouraging others from paying their church taxes.
We promised the Reverend 30 cords of wood in salary. As it is, he'd be out of wood by the Sabbath. If they can't support him, we, the village committee, must force the collection.
Have pity.
If my waywardness be visited, discourage and humble beseech thee, have pity on this world, and praise the and may my soul discourage.
Why are you taking them? Please don't. Please stop.
Anne, enough.
Three of my babies dead at birth. You are Christ's ambassador. Please tell me, why is God doing this to me? Why?
Would you like to marry, Mercy? A butcher.
A butcher?
Yes. And we live in town and every night go to bed with a full belly.
I'd like to marry a tailor like Goodman Cummings. Husband's hands are fine and always clean.
Always clean. Cleaner than your own, then. And how should that look?
Stop it. Tis it true.
Stop.
has fooled William Proctor. He can mimic any bird he can name. Ask him.
Not any.
Can you do a horned owl? A wooden thrush. A whippoorwill. Oh, please, William.
Can you do a lovebird?
Chosen specially by God. When you fail him, you open the door to Satan. With your unseemly speeches, you open the door to Satan. With your theft, you open the door. You are a sinner. With your unholy fornication, you are a sinner. With your doubts about God's presence, you are a sinner. You will be taken from village to village so that all can see your sins, and by this public humiliation, you will be purged of your private weaknesses. And may God be with you.
Mary, Mary, take this amulet. It will keep harm away.
Bridget Bishop, you keep away from her, you filthy hag.
No, Bridget!
Avail your eyes, Mary!
Stay away from me! Get away!
Not thou witchwoman! Not thou witchwoman!
Know ye this! As you make your journey, the pain you are suffering without the spurious comfort of amulets wrought on the anvils of witchcraft is for your own salvation, and therefore it is righteous.
Scraps for us today. My little girl is famished.
Come back later, goody good. Tituba, give you food then.
You're a good Puritan, you are. Taking care of your poor Christian neighbors. Not like the others. Like you, Goody Walcott. Casting your own hungry neighbors out in the cold. Do you answer to Satan?
Quiet, you old harridan. You're crazed and you're intellectuals.
Tisn't true.
Tis. Burned until you are dead.
Tituba, is it true? A fever will burn your brain away?
And your soul, too, unless you've been baptized.
Tishaba?
Betty, child, the Parks will not come here. The cards told me.
What cards?
A cards my shaman friend in Barbados taught me to read. To tell the future.
The ones that'll tell if we'll be scalped by Indians.
Scalped?
Except for you. Because then you'd be an orphan like Mercy Lewis.
Abigail, you mustn't scare your cousin anymore. Listen to Tishaba.
Mama? What is an orphan?
Shh.
Am I one?
Quiet, children. You must not speak unless you are dressed.
But, Mama!
Enough. I must go rest, Tituba. There's a distemper in my head. It feels that it will burst. It's a consumption. I pray that it is not.
Mom, we're almost out of wood again.
I shall mention it to the Reverend.
Mama, am I an orphan?
Please, Reverend, I have done my penance.
That is enough, Mary Godfrey. Show me your obedience.
Please, Reverend, I have confessed to my guilt of unseemly practices. I did covet a bolt of fabric. My husband struck me for it, and I did strike him back. Will you not forgive my sins? I wish to be part of this church.
You plead to me with words, but by your actions of lustful covetousness, you have chosen to align yourself with the devil. This church does not harbor sinners.
I have sinned. Now I have repented. Why won't you hear it?
Mind your place, wife.
Where's your forgiveness? Can you honestly swear before God that you have never sinned yourself?
Sinner, if you're resolved in your way, be assured you are going to dwell with the devils and the damned and be tormented by the flames of hell, where you will be filled brimful in body and soul with the wrath of God.
Shame upon our house.
Who next wishes to speak?
I do.
Speak, and pardon.
I fear there is some weakness in my conviction. I know not what, for I am righteous and diligent in my prayers. But something in my soul is stained. And this is why they die. What have I done? Please lead me to what I have done so that I could find forgiveness.
Heaven is large, Ann Putnam, if you are virtuous enough. Yet there is but one way into this happiness. It is narrow, with a little gate. And if you miss this gate, you lose all your labor and shall never come to salvation. Do not lose your faith, Ann Putnam.
But can't you tell me what I've done?
Do not lose your faith.
The Lord has given us a gift of much work to do, but we must also take time for ourselves to do nothing. Like this. Walk. It helps ease the heart, make you forget.
And what will make my body forget? My breasts are still full of milk for the child, and my arms ache to hold him. How much walking attempt? My body forgets this.
The good Lord will not let us suffer forever. Have faith in that.
Faith.
He said school should only be a place where children learn the three R's. Samuel? Have you not heard a word? Samuel.
What else can I do for these people?
Children, let us say grace.
Not enough for him to sue me for my land for all these years. Now Thomas Putnam is ordering my wood to be taken for the minister's salary.
How much would the Putnams themselves tithing, if any? 'Tis all anyone is discussing.
Have you the oil of flaxseed and the root of verbena?
Never heard of it.
It cures distemper of the womb and solves the mystery of a stillbirth.
There is no transcendence in suffering.
Richard Bishop, will you receive me?
I am Ann Putnam.
I know who you are.
I am afraid.
Then turn to your God, churchwoman. Pray for your mercy there, not here.
I have tried.
No human people call me. You would be excommunicated if found here. Are you not afraid of hell?
I care not that you are called a witch, and I am already in hell. Please, tell me why my children are dying. You know the answer.
I am not a witch. Although 'tis what I am called. But I will tell you something that no one else has uttered to you. You are not to blame.
I am. Thank you.
Come inside, and I will tell you all I know.
Bishop is a witch. Satan's witch. Satan's witch. Satan's witch.
That's enough. This will stop.
Satan's witch. Satan's witch. Everyone knows of her evil. Bridget Bishop is a...
Tom.
She's a witch.
You should be struck. Stop it.
Arrested for keeping me own wood to myself. Can the Putnams do that?
They are the village committee. They can do it.
It's important.
Has your brother sent you to protect his notice? You're gonna arrest me, Goodman Putnam.
No. No, I'm only half a Putnam, Goodman Proctor. It's something I'm reminded of almost daily. It is not village business I wish to discuss with you. But this. It is an Indian carving. The finest I have yet found. Might you give it to Lizzie?
After all these months of admiring her, can you not find a way to give it to her yourself?
I could have, yes.
But you wanted me to know that your interest in my daughter is official.
Yes, sir. I did. It is.
I will give it to her. With my blessings.
God be with you then.
And, Joseph, I shall expect you to visit me sometime soon. An official visit.
Yes, I shall, sir. Thank you.
Did you feel the air shift just then? Everything has just changed.
Oh, look! It's Joseph Putnam!
Where?
He's come to ask for Lizzie's hand!
Stop it! Stop it! There could be 100 reasons why he would call on Father.
But only one that matters. Shh. I believe Enid is right. You shall marry a fine man.
Stop it!
And he's the richest of all.
Both of you must stop! It is obscene to talk this way.
Shh!
Stop it! It is enough! Shh, Lita, tell them to stop.
Everyone knows that young Joseph has been courting you. And the blush on your face is confirmation enough.
See, even Lita.
Shh! It is enough, girls!
My good wife, Putnam. But it's part of curse. A wife of his must cope with Thomas and Edward. I am brothers-in-law such as these should be a constant chafe on a poor wife.
But why, Lita? Why are they so hateful to Joseph? He's heard everywhere. Why?
Because his mother was not theirs. And she left most of her estate and all the Putnam lands to Joseph and Joseph alone. Why, they shall never forgive him. And he has no other family. You shall be all of it for him now, my fine lass.
Stop it.
Over there is the port of Salem Town. You are aware of that, yes?
Have you asked me here to give me a lesson in geography?
Of course not. The future. The future. Your grandfather and mine were the richest men in Salem. Yours, I believe, owned over 700 acres of land.
It was that much, yes.
And yet today, except for you, not one of the Putnams has enough land to support another generation.
Yes.
The Putnams believe that they've been wronged by their neighbors, and so they bring lawsuit after lawsuit. They believe that God has turned his back on them, and so they hire a new minister. Anything but to see the truth. New England's wealth will not come from the land. That is the future. Shipping. Commerce. Not farming. The Putnams haven't been so stubborn. They would have seen this when my father did. I mean no offense.
None taken. I'm more outcast than Putnam.
I know that. That is why I accept your request for my daughter in marriage. As soon as you get around to it, I would like to offer you the future.
Marriage? May I? Rather, Goodman Porter, I would like to offer my marriage for your daughters. I mean...
It's all right. Your words are nonsense, but your meaning is clear. I accept your request. A father is blessed when he can make a marriage that is rich in love. And in this case, with the marriage of the Porter and Putnam assets, we shall bring the future to us. I will not pretend that does not please me as well.
No! No, I forbid it, do you hear? A Putnam shall never marry a Porter. Never!
It's my right to do as I...
I am the eldest. I say what is right and what is not.
Thomas, what do you to him?
Leave us.
Joseph wishes to marry Lizzie Porter.
And I shall.
Upstairs, you.
I do not need your permission for this or any other decision I make. Shout, strike me, it makes no difference.
Thomas, have you lost your senses?
This is Israel Porter's design to steal more of my land. He will trade his own daughter for it.
Liar! Don't speak thus of her.
Israel Porter was the executor of your mother's estate. You believe he's not been planning this for the 18 years of your life?
Hold your tongue! You shame yourself for such slander. It is you who have wished me ill for all my years. And if you raise your hand to me, I swear to God you shall lose it.
Is my greatest wish.
Now, all of you, into the keeping room. We have victuals and spiced wine. Eat up, spiced wine.
You are too late.
They are married.
You shall pay for this, Ezra Porter. You and that thieving brother.
There's naught you can do. Not your anger, not another legal suit. You cannot harm them now.
You shall pay for conniving against me, Ezra Porter. Let God hear me now. You shall pay for this.
Come.
Is no less than a rot in this village. Has God determined that the Putnam shall inherit no more than an aggregate of loss? This is not the Puritanism that my grandfather came to Salem for. You were brought here to strengthen us, but you do not.
You cast the glare of blame on me, but this is a time for patience.
There is no time. The wolf is at the door.
I have scripted my sermons to lead and unite
and
this
no
community.
One is listening. You were brought here to restore order. That is why we met each of your demands. We gave you the land that you sleep upon each night. We agreed to your salary.
Agreed to it, aye, but have not yet delivered it. How can I pen the sermons we need when the very ink freezes on my quill? Where is my wood?
Where is my order? You shall have your wood, and we shall expect the return to Puritanism that you were brought here for.
Are we going down?
Shh. It is a sin to listen to them like this.
But I did not mean to listen.
Quiet. Do not speak. Do not even think. The devil will hear you and will make you his witch.
What? Simple dearth of wood causes this frown? You doubt me still. You may say it, wife.
I am afraid, yes. The villagers were to pay us in wood. Why aren't they, Samuel? Forgive me.
Elizabeth.
I'm afraid that it will not work out again for us, Samuel. And I haven't the strength anymore to start afresh. Will there be talk about us?
Will I fail again?
We need not discuss it.
The past has made me stronger, Elizabeth. That is what you need to understand. The past has given me a knowledge of hardship that the two reverends before me did not have. And that is why they failed here. But I can heal this place.
I know you can.
There is a fear in this village, Elizabeth, that is stronger even than your own. They have a need of me. I can feel it. Rest assured.
Stop! Stop!
Stop! What are they doing?
Are you thieving?
Do not stop. Keep working, keep working.
What is this? On the young land, you would steal the wood that I cut and hauled and split with my own hands?
You owe a cord, Giles Corey. By order of Thomas Putnam and vote of the village committee, you have been assessed 1 cord of wood in taxes.
1 cord of wood?
Well, I refuse. Put down that wood.
Then you shall be arrested. Here is my order.
Giles?
Sleep, baby, go sleep. Mama has gone to town. When she come back, she gon' give you to slumber.
What's a lust?
So go to sleep, baby, go sleep.
Carnal cravings. Stand side by side. Always ready to cast their evil shadows on the righteous light of Jesus Christ. People lust.
People lie.
I am to make the difference between the clean and the unclean, so as to confirm the one and purge the other. I shall be your guide on earth. I shall lead you to the narrow gate of heaven and into the grace of God for eternity. I know the sinners. And I know the righteous. People lust. People lie. Children lie as well. They are not too young to know evil. And they are not too little to die, so they are not too little to be damned. Know ye this? Hell is a terrible place that's worse 1,000 times than a whipping. And it waits for you.
Betty, such a noise will bother your mama. She is sick now.
Is it the pox?
I told you no already. Go outside and fetch some more wood. You too, Abigail.
But I don't want to.
Betty, do as you're told.
But Satan is outside, and he put himself...
You can't hide from the devil, inside or outside, doesn't matter.
But I don't want to. I want to stay here.
Are you Satan's child? It is a sin to disobey. Ask forgiveness. Now.
But, Mama, I am afraid.
Both of you. Pray that you will not be stained by such manners. Do it.
For the love of my people, I must place my whole being in the hands of Jesus, my Redeemer.
Thank God you meant your words. You can't vote me off the village committee.
Yes, and your brothers and cousins.
You cannot steal our property.
That's right.
It's time for new leadership, Thomas.
Yes.
Our village must have its own minister.
Tell us why.
Have you not seen the erosion in our standings while Salem town has...
Mr. Pastor!
It is against God's will.
Master Mr. Putnam, you mistake your own self-interest for God's will. This hypocrisy must stop.
Give him some of your own wood, Thomas Putnam.
We already have a meeting house in San
You have
Thomas.
Gone too far!
Another one!
From this day forward, the Salem Village Committee will consist of my brother, Joseph Porter.
Yeah. No. This cannot be!
My brother-in-law!
I will uphold the Puritanism of my grandfather! The Putnams will stand as one against those that would profit by it!
If you are looking for a Putnam, sir, I'll give you a Putnam. My son-in-law, Joseph Putnam.
Yes!
You will not neuter me with your votes.
Oh, yes.
I am a Putnam!
What is this? Are you not well again?
I've heard that your brother's fury is not abated. The village is split like a ripe melon.
Shh, wife. A baby will not want to be born into such a place as you make Salem sound. Do you fear I shall be as poor a committee leader as I am with your hand wheel?
The village shall be as knotted as our flags. If only our village were no more than the four corners of this room.
Imagine it is. But I shall never let harm enter it.
I am afraid, Joseph. It is not just Thomas's black hair. Something is happening in the village, and all are aware of it. Tarbell's corn rotted overnight in its crib. And Abigail Williams says she saw a small bird that she swears was a witch's familiar. People are saying that Satan has come to the village because it is impure.
Not listen to people talking.
The fear is everywhere. I feel it myself, and with our child coming.
Shh! You are safe, Lizzie. And I would lay down my life to keep you that way.
And what of your brother's anger? Do you not fear that?
I fear only the thought that one day you will stop loving.
Nothing to fear in the world.
With this petition, they've taken a new committee leader. Their first act will be to void the tax that pays your salary. And next, they intend to reclaim the land under the meeting house. They believe it was unrightfully given to you.
These are the men who would wage war on a Puritan minister.
Yes, but this is far from over. We will form a new petition.
God does not listen, and we may as well not exist.
Yes, it is what I've been fearing this last
time. Do not say it again.
These are the words of an infidel.
It'll snow tomorrow. There's a ring round the moon.
These are not safe times, Anne. You must take care in your words.
In front of you.
In front of God.
have not. Please let me know you do not blame me for this. To know that would remove the pith of my suffering. When these weeks of prayers have done not. Please comfort me, husband. And I shall bring thee another child.
What comfort is it when it brings but stillness and grief to our hearts? Go to sleep.
You shall feel better now with the warmth.
Yes, I feel stronger already, thank you.
There's plenty of wood in the shed, have you seen?
Yes, yes, but I'm tired, Samuel. I must sleep.
In time, Elizabeth, this will feel like our home. Will it not?
Salem should be our home when our congregation supports us of their own will. If it is not divine inspiration, but threat of harm that moves them, Samuel, how does this bode for us?
If they were divinely inspired, there would be no need of me. The threat of harm will be felt only by those who lack faith.
I do not want to lose everything yet again.
Perhaps God has brought me here, Elizabeth. He took away our farm in Barbados to give us this. Yes, my brother has my family's estate, but we have this. A chance to do God's work. You may lack faith in me, but perhaps God does not.
Watch it now, girls. What is it going to be?
What is it, Tishuba?
Well, it looks like an apron. A cobbler's apron.
No, it is a scythe. Look at it here.
Oh, yes, a scythe.
You shall marry a farmer.
A farmer?
Wait, it has not finished turning yet. It has finished turning. She's a scythe.
Tituba.
Coming, ma'am. Clean it up now, girls. Before you get caught.
Tis right on now.
Shh.
Quiet, Annie.
We shall be discovered.
We must stop.
Quiet. Tis my turn next.
It's the devil's game you play. Tell him, Abigail. God hears us.
No one hears us, Betty. No one.
Child, calm yourself.
Calm yourself. Niece, step here to help me.
Are they ill? What's happening to the children? Reverend.
I know not. My Betty and Abigail suffer in the same way. Niece, help me.
Oh, Dr. Briggs, please. Someone tell me what's happening to my child.
They are in fits, Goody Putnam.
Annie, can you not speak? Mercy, they were fine when they left here. What harm have they encountered while they were with you?
Nothing. They were gathered to play some game.
What game? What game?
I know not what game it was, but this is the result. Niece, bring me my medicines, for God's sake.
Barking, whining, foaming from their lips.
I've heard unable to breathe and more fall to the fits every day.
I've heard five girls so far.
I've heard Mercy Lewis attempted to burn herself in the fireplace.
No, the way I heard it, she flew into it like a bird. She was trying to fly up the fireplace. It took two men to hold her back.
Oh, my God, help this child. It is witchcraft.
Little Betty Paris has boils all over her body.
Well, perhaps it's a fungus. What she needs is a poultice.
No, 'tis not fungus ails them, nor are they poor innocents afflicted by witchcraft. They are possessed by the devil. They are doing his work.
You think they are witches themselves?
I think that should not be ruled out.
Forgive me. It is usually empty now. I come to pay my respects.
Forgive me.
Oh, no, please. Surely our Lord would rather hear your prayers than my cleaning for him. May I sit down?
Of course.
Are the children improving?
I fear not. Some days they give me hope.
They are in my prayers every day. Oh, I find such comfort here.
Do you recognize? I fear I am at fault. I led Satan to my door. It is why these things are happening.
Oh, Goody Putnam. You have received God's communion in this church. You are one of his chosen.
No. I lost faith. My prayers were only words. I turned elsewhere for solace.
Elsewhere?
Yes. And I sought the comfort of an infidel. It is why this is happening. I have drawn no witness. But the rod of it is festering inside me. And I pray that you tell no one. I should not have spoken. The ache of my sins is too to be.
Oh, Goody Putnam, God will not forsake you. You have received his communion. Now go to God. Reverend Paris will show you the way. Believe in him, and God will listen.
Putnam.
I've got nothing for you today, Goody Good.
Not what I've come for. I wish to pay my Christian respects to the children. Annie's a good girl.
And the maid, too. Both are godly and the village prays for them. Might you tell them that?
Thank you.
Might we see them? Dorcas here made him a toy. It isn't much, but we're poor.
Of course. Come on.
People have said it has been 3 days without a bite of food. Not even a word.
Not a word known to humans, anyway.
Grunting like animals is what I heard.
I made you a toy.
Don't get near them.
So, you've come to taunt them with your stares?
Haven't either. I don't want my girl to be afflicted.
How dare you? They are not witches.
It's not what's being said. Look at them. It's not human. Satan possesses them.
Get out. And hear me, Sarah Good. If harm comes to these children because of the black rumors of your tongue, ye shall be sorry. I promise you, ye shall be sorry.
To check the refined power of my natural mind. To live entirely to thy glory, to be deaf to unmerited censure and the praise of men. Nothing can hurt my newborn inner man that cannot be smitten or die. Nothing can mar the dominion.
Who approaches?
'Tis I, Reverend Paris. Lizzie Putnam. I was hoping you would allow a moment to speak in private.
About?
Pray you do not think me crazed, Reverend.
Speak, child. I can think nothing until you confess.
It was a dream I had. Woke me with a terrible fear. Without breath. Without my wits as well. Someone was there in my room. I was sure of it, but I saw nothing. And yet, I knew with as much surety as you sit here, flesh and blood, in front of me now. What is happening, Reverend? Was it a witch or a familiar? I've heard of these, but I dare not speak of them to naught but you.
Keep your secret between us. Unwarranted talk of witches and familiars breeds a rapid fear in a village. Lizzie, I have watched the devotion of your prayers on the Sabbath. You are lovely of spirit and complexion. It is likely that Satan would covet one as pure as you.
Then am I bewitched?
Pray with me. Know ye that the godly bask in the fellowship of other pious people as well as in the light of God.
I plant my jasmine garden, my jasmine smells so sweet. Jasmine, come when I call ya. Jasmine, come when I call ya. Jasmine, come when I call you. Jasmine, come when I call you. That is their favorite one, but they don't hear. They don't shut their eyes. They neither sleep nor wake. There is talk they are possessed, but I don't...
Bah! That is untrue. See to Elizabeth.
Yes, master.
Ails you. You will answer me. Speak. The devil is
not possess you. It does not possess you.
Reverend?
Your wife knows.
I came to pray for the children. May I?
Yes, yes, yes. Of course. We shall both pray. And in tandem, God cannot help but hear our plea. O Lord, whose power is infinite and wisdom infallible.
Why is this happening?
Reverend Paris. Reverend. You are saving them.
Forgive me. Oh Lord, whose power is infinite and wisdom infallible.
I say this because hypocrites are the most diabolical of sinners. Christ said to his apostles, "Have I not chosen you 12? Yet one of you is the devil's disciple." And there are such disciples in this church. Ye who sit here wearing the mask of piety and yet are not pious. Ye are of your father the devil. And Christ knows. Time enough, ye heretics, time enough. Have but little patience, and ye shall see hell in time enough.
No! No! No!
Say to the afflicted girl!
Tis Mary Warren! The proctor's maid!
Children, get upstairs, go to your rooms. Can you? Sarah, all of you, now!
They're sticking me! They're
sticking me! Mary, you'll be
out of
the
prison
post. I promise you,
girl,
enough of this. You
be gentle with her!
Good Jesus, she is afflicted!
No, she is not. This is not but fakery!
Mother, please!
I'll throw you out into the street.
Please,
you hear me, girl? You'll be as homeless as the day I found you, girl.
Please! Albert! She's with child!
Child.
It is mine. No improvement.
It's been thus for days. With hands and legs flailing till we bound them to save her own bones. And when she stops, she's as still as stiff.
She's like the others.
You must do something, I beg of you.
My own niece is afflicted. And May Walcott, she's the ninth so far. I am sorry. Good day, Reverend.
God be with you.
Not to do, but watch the suffering.
We have prayer.
Children are suffering. Our own daughter.
Let us pray. It be not in vain.
O Lord, Son of God Almighty, I beseech thee, heed our prayer. Accept into your divine grace the tormented prayers of these your worshipful servants. Can you not feel it, children? God's presence.
Perhaps they are possessed.
Yes. Perhaps the devil orders them not to speak.
No. These innocents are afflicted. They are not possessed.
What afflicts you?
Get away! Get away! Get off! Fighting me!
What ails you? What is it?
house of God. Be not afraid. What afflicts you?
A witch! A witch! A witch afflicts me!
Where be this witch?
Witches.
Constable, not this one. Not yet.
Come here.
Master, I don't...
Why have you afflicted the children?
I've never heard the children. I love them like they're my own.
How long have you served Satan?
I don't serve Satan.
You have sullied my home from the beginning. You are a harbinger of damnation, witch.
You are a witch.
You are a force of Satan in my own home.
No.
You shall confess and purify us of his evil.
I'm not a witch, I'm a good girl.
You lie! I speak for God. You shall confess or know the wrath of the Almighty for eternity. You shall confess and repent.
Afraid. I fear they become afflicted.
My thoughts are often dizzying. You're not but them.
It will be over soon, wife. The witches have been exposed, and soon all three will be hanging from the gallows. And you'll have naught to think about but a name for our baby. Do you not believe me? Be over by tomorrow.
But I cannot believe that. Tituba.
Mm-hmm.
Why would the child still be crying for her? Is it not possible they've taken it the wrong way?
What's she crying for?
Tituba, Elizabeth. She's crying because of Tituba. Betty will confront her tormentor.
Then I shall go with her.
No, you shall not. You shall tend to your illness. It shall be but a day, Elizabeth. I shall draw a confession from the witches and we shall be purged. Rest assured.
My corn overnight.
Oh, that's absurd.
For all I know, she burned down my barn.
Village.
Sarah, good.
I have found cause enough to have you tried as a witch.
Yes. You should be returned to prison until the date of your trial. Remove her.
You are Sarah Osborne.
And you shall both be hanging.
You shall see soon enough. God is no longer in this world for us. I do not hurt them.
Look at them, they are suffering.
Look at them!
She is my flesh! My flesh, okay? I am innocent!
Teach you the Indian.
The Lord Almighty shall strike you! Answer, are you a witch?
Yes!
And Satan speaks to you.
Yes.
Is he speaking to you now, this very meeting?
Yes.
What doth he say? Answer. For the sake of the children. The Lord Almighty shall strike you. What doth Satan instruct you?
To hurt the children.
To hurt the blessed children?
Hi, Alice.
Are there more witches? Ask her! Ask her!
Are there more witches?
Tell us!
Yes, tell us!
Tell us,
witch!
Tell us, witch!
Are
there more witches?
Tell us! Ask her, Reverend!
Tituba.
than more. Speak, are there others?
Yes. There are other witches amongst us. Witches amongst us.
Take this witch to prison and let her await her trial.
The devil walks with her!
Be hung because of you, witch!
I am not a witch!
Witch! Are you confessed, witch?
No! He beat me! I had to tell him something. He beat me!
You beat me to stop it! Stop it! Stop it! Stop it! Stop it! No, stop it!
To us.
Without repentance, they must be hanged.
Unfortunately, there is no law, Reverend. Until the colonies have a charter, we cannot even bring them to trial, let alone hang them.
These are Satan's witches.
And we are civilized men. We have no legal authority.
Time to wait on politics. We've been without a charter for 4 years. Today alone, two more girls fell into fits of affliction.
There is word from Boston that Increase Mather is en route from England, even as we speak.
And if the King's not signed the charter, we wait another 4 years. Goodman, we must act expeditiously. Our souls will be consumed.
No. We must wait until Increase Mather has returned.
Poor children. Can you hear me? How can I save you? I'm afraid. Is that it? You are afraid too? Of us. What? God. You are afraid of God.
Enough, Lizzie.
Give me a deeper knowledge of myself.
You need to see.
His Savior, Master, Lord, and King. Give me your
Stop
deeper
it,
holiness in speech, action, and action. Give me.
What is happening?
I'm so afraid. I'm afraid.
Why? Why? I will let nothing harm you.
I'm afraid not being pure enough for our baby.
Coming!
Easy!
Easy!
That's it! That's it!
Calm yourself!
Nay!
Quiet down, child! It's your father!
Come out of there, girl!
Nay, it's your father! It's your
father! Louise is burning me! Louise is burning me!
I don't believe it. I'm saying it's evil mischief.
It's not mischief. Nothing human sounds like that. It's enough to make a sane man lose his intellectuals.
Can you not smell my flesh of fire?
Speak, May. Who afflicts you? Who burns you?
The witch! The witch!
Witch. Speak her now. Speak her name.
I know who it is.
Bridget Bishop, come out. She's gone.
She's turned herself into a bird. She heard us coming. She's a witch.
She'd hear us breathing from a mile away.
Annie, mind the soup.
Draw more.
Annie. Mind the soup.
Draw more.
Child, you dare defy your mother's request. Mind the soup.
Help me. Help me, Goody Putnam. They have come to arrest me. They have burned my home. I've been all night in the forest. Another night and I shall die of cold. You can stop them. Please. Anne Putnam, you know I am not a witch. I helped you, Anne Putnam, when you had nowhere else to turn, not even your gods. And I saved you. You can stop them!
Beware ye now, I say. Satan himself has announced his presence in Salem. From this day, the devil and his instruments will be warring with double vengeance against our salvation. Remove these children from the devil's shadow. Spare them any more suffering. They have served Christ enough for one day.
Can you see them, Annie? Can you see the specters?
God bless you, mercy, Lewis. Save us, Annie!
God bless you. God be with you.
Bah, I don't believe it. Is the girl's making mischief, I say. Or perhaps it is worse. How do we know they are not the devil's witches?
How do we know they are not the
devil's
witches?
Sheriff!
Come
on,
man,
Macaulay!
Do not be wrong with her!
You take your hands away!
Hear me! Do not harm her!
You dare accuse me! I am a member of the church! I received the law from you! Tis the girls or the devil's agents! You will see, let me be tried! I will prove who is a witch!
My good reverend, how are you?
Increase, Mather. These 4 years have changed you little. Welcome home. The crossing was bearable, I trust.
Only just. My advanced years become all too known to me on the sea.
Oh, the only time I feel old is when somebody younger than myself starts complaining about the advancing years. Please sit down.
There are matters we must discuss, Master.
You bring good news, I trust.
Actually, even
have you failed in your mission? The charter is signed, is it?
Colonies have their charter. Their Majesties agreed to many of our needs, but...
Excellent, excellent. I can imagine nothing more important than that this document should be signed. Can you imagine, Increase? Our life has been here for the last 4 years without any formal government. I mean, it's been absolutely... No.
Excuse me, sir.
Not now. I'm talking to the river. Who are you?
That is my wife, Lady Mary Phipps.
I'm not referring to her.
This is Sir William Phipps. He is the new governor of Massachusetts. Just a matter I was hoping to discuss.
William Phipps? Not the adventurer? And he's going to be the governor of Massachusetts?
By order of King William and Queen Mary.
I assure you, a role will be found. There is no reason why your work in the colonies should have to be stopped.
My work is for God, Mr. Phipps.
Sir, Reverend. Sir William Phipps.
May we have more wood on the fire?
No.
My husband prefers a warmer room.
Certainly, my lady.
Splendid, my sweet. Ah, here we are.
Before we start talking about, as it were, the housekeeping, which I admit is as pressing as anything contained in the Royal Charter, which happens to be lying here on my desk, what role had you envisaged for me in your new administration?
Witchcraft, Reverend.
Witchcraft?
The news of its invasion into the colonies much concerns England. Their Majesties will be watching us carefully to see that it is handled without undue disruption. The latest news is that the devil is not satisfied with just beggars and slaves. He has started to possess respectable souls. Obviously. His evil hand reaches deeper than we first imagined.
God. God. Bring us more soup. God.
Quiet, witch. Let Satan serve you.
Please. Goody good a second with child. Please. We need more soup. Please. We would wait. Wait. Please.
Goody Corey. You have been accused.
Only a matter of time for this witch.
Move, slave.
That is her spot.
You defend a witch?
Are you a witch?
Of course not. The girl's lied.
Then call her Tituba. She is no different than you. We're all as much witch as each other.
Good day, Corey. Is there word from outside?
There are rumors. This will be over soon. The fools. They shall learn who'll be responsible.
Over. Tell us what you know.
Tell us.
Please. We beg you.
Yes, please, please.
There is a new charter. And a new governor.
And he will favor us.
'Tis the rumor.
Oh. Did you hear that? He might favor us. He might favor us. The sneers of the parents of the temptations of
heaven. Easy. We're getting close to Salem Village. There's a blackbird up there.
That would be expected. It's where birds are most comfortable.
Do you mock me?
I was merely offering a scientific hypothesis.
Oh, you're a man of science, is that it?
I must admit, I take some comfort from the logic of it.
And is that the way you intend to govern the state of Massachusetts? With the scientific logic as your guide?
Rather a modern concept, isn't it, Reverend?
In the hell in which we're about to enter, Sir William, I assure you that your scientific logic will have the impact of a jet of urine in the ocean. Rank and tepid at the outset, but it quickly loses its identity as it mingles with the far greater waves of faith and godliness. We are entering Salem Village, where the devil has taken up residence. The devil. And not all your science will protect you or the inhabitants.
We are in Salem to find the truth, Reverend. Can you honestly trust that you will be able to see it with so much salt water in your eyes?
I've reviewed the documents of the accused witches. I was struck by how many of the complaints were filed by you, Goodman Putnam. Perhaps a third so far.
I shall not let Satan get a foothold in Salem.
Two of the accusers live in your house.
My own daughter's afflicted.
Ah, then it is understandable why you are so vigilant.
Gentlemen, shall we repair to my study?
I was also struck, Goodman Putnam, by how many of the accused are of families engaged in prior litigation with your own? Land disputes, sir, other legal...
I hope, Sir William, you're not insinuating
that I... Nothing. Life is full of coincidences. They fascinate me.
The governor is a man of science.
An evil hand is upon us, Sir William, there is no doubt.
You have presided over the examinations of the accused, have you not?
Yes, it has been...
26 examinations to date.
27. We examined another this morning.
And how many of those examined do you believe to be witches?
27.
All of them?
Yes.
Have they all confessed?
Just one. But
26 people have pleaded their innocence, and you have believed not even one of them.
The guilt of the accused, Sir William, is beyond doubt. They have been examined very carefully.
Examined for their witchcraft?
Of course.
Or for their innocence?
Gona, these are servants and wives of Satan. Their specters have afflicted a score of innocent young girls.
Specters?
Have any of these witches transformed themselves into birds?
Yes. Yellow ones.
My daughter saw a black one, yes, biting her. Those are the witches' familiars. They suckle from the young girls. Snakes?
Yes. Cats as well. The girls have all seen them.
And have any of these witches passed into the young girls' rooms during the night as these familiars?
Even through locked doors, it is how they materialize.
And that, for your information, Governor, that is a specter.
Thank you, Sir William. The poor afflicted girls bend and writhe and suffer in ways that defy the laws of science.
Yes. So I have heard.
You shall see for yourself at the trials.
Regretfully, I shall not. I am en route to the frontier. I must admit I have had more experience fighting Indians than witches. For the time being, I shall place my deputy governor in charge of the trials. I should be glad to know what he finds.
Well, I shall remain your humble and obedient servant, as always, sir.
I wish you luck, Reverend. Gentlemen.
Governor.
You must immediately shackle all the witches in prison. This will help contain their specters. Now, quickly.
We shall see to it.
At once. I should like to see the children now, please.
Please.
The children are resting, I'm afraid.
Their afflictions caused so much conversation in Boston, I was very eager to study them for myself.
They're not to be studied. They're neither curiosities nor insults.
Forgive my wife, Reverend Stoughton. She's been ill for some time now. The fever makes her lose her senses. Elizabeth? Come this way.
Thank you. Children, they do not seem to be afflicted, not as I've heard. Oh,
there are times they seem normal, but as you see, they're quite thin, except for the darkness under the eyes. The skin has turned disturbingly pale during the ordeal. Rest yourself.
Is this calm one your daughter?
She is not calm, Reverend.
Oh? Oh, yes, I see. Is this typical?
She will remain like this for hours.
Do you think I might ask for a candle? We will go for trial.
I shall call the slave first. She confessed.
No. No, leave the confessors until last. First, we will call on those who think they can evade the truth.
Bishop, are you prepared to confess to the crime of witchcraft?
If she has a fever, you will give her these herbs and water.
Bridget Bishop.
Bridget, God bless you.
Let her know you love her.
Bridget Bishop, it is your time for trial.
I am guilty of nothing. I know nothing of it. I do not even know this man.
Liar! Witch! She's come to me in the night many times, with naught but a red corset above her waist.
I did not!
How did she get through your door?
The spectre flew in without making a noise. Who else but a witch could do this?
It was not me!
Bridget Bishop, we have spectral evidence in this case. And you have heard the accusations of the girls. You have afflicted them.
No, they are mistaken!
They are mistaken!
Must they mock me?
Must they mock me?
Shut this!
You bewitch them.
I do not.
But look at them. Did you not cast a spell over them?
They are making mischief.
And will you say that I lie as well? While my wife sleeps beside me, this witch flies in, puts herself on top of me.
Bridget Bishop,
Confess, are you a witch?
No!
Then why will no one speak for you?
Not one person.
They are afraid to speak.
Shameless spectre!
Satan's servant!
Hang the witch!
Bridget Bishop, the evidence against you damns you. You are hereby convicted for the crime of witchcraft, and you are to be hanged by the neck until you are dead.
This to you. Abigail, do you
you know?
Was the old man.
Reverend Stoughton?
It was God. We were bad.
We are leaving. The children can no longer stay here. We shall not return.
What is this impudence?
You cannot leave. The children are witnesses.
No, they are children, not witnesses, not spectacles, not things to be brought out and put on display for your purposes. They are children!
Wife!
Wait outside, children. Wait outside.
You cannot leave. I am the minister. I have not been pained enough with a confessed witch under my own roof and two of the afflicted.
They are not afflicted. They are terrified of you.
Your fever taints your thoughts. It is your illness that provokes you to this.
No, the illness is in that meeting house. It is carried in upon your own fear, and in turn you have infected this village with it. Can you not see what you have done?
I'm protecting them from Satan's grasp.
But they would not need protecting if the God you hear in your head offered compassion. Just that.
Elizabeth.
Force me to stay and I shall speak. From my heart.
And they have taken seriously ill, both of them?
Yes, these last few months became too much for them. Taking them away was my wife's idea. She felt that in their unhealthy state, children would unfairly sway the judgment of the accused.
There is order in your house, is there not, Reverend?
Yes, of course. Why should there not be?
Won't you stop and hear me? Me poor wife is innocent. She's a churchwoman, same as you. Her only crime was to doubt. Neighbors, can you not see this? Can you not see that this is unholy mischief in this?
Giles Corey, you're in trial for the crime of witchcraft. How do you plead?
I shall not dignify this travesty with a plea.
Guilty or innocent? The court demands that you enter a plea. Guilty or innocent? Giles Corey, it is the law of the land that you must stand trial. Guilty? Or innocent?
Answer!
I order that the defendant suffer pain fought endure until such a time as he changes mind, removes it. Another stone. Guilty or innocent? Three drafts of water today, three morsels of bread tomorrow, nothing more.
shall not. You don't need beside the still waters. You restore my son. He maketh me to lie down in the still waters. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his own sake.
How do you plead, Giles Corey? Guilty or innocent?
Giles! Oh, no! 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 Stop!
He spoke, sir.
Guilty or innocent?
Ma, wait.
Another?
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Let thy kingdom come. Thy will be fulfilled as well on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, even as we forgive our trespasses.
Arthur Curry, will you confess to the crime of witchcraft?
Temptation. But deliver us from evil.
Do you confess,
for thine
Martha Curry?
And the power and the glory forever.
Martha Curry!
Amen.
Will you answer?
Did you not hear my prayer? The fullness.
Jesus, my Redeemer. Check the I cannot.
Do not lose your faith in but to check.
Faith in what?
I'm innocent!
Is that God's love?
It is hard for me as well, Anne. But it is a test for us. The path to our God is not easy. This is how we shall show our Puritanism. Now look. Look.
I cannot.
Anne, stay strong. You do not want to show that you are weak in your faith. Look at it.
Mary Lacey.
No. Stop it.
You confess to the crime of witchcraft.
No, no, no. Yes, yes, yes. I confess. I'm a witch.
Forgive me. I will lay myself before thee and beg for mercy. I confess.
Reverend Parrish, we will accord these unfortunate women one final chance of redemption, the evening prayer.
O lover of thy people, thou hast placed my whole being in the hands of Jesus, my Redeemer.
They have sinned against God. This is their punishment. It is God's will. His will. They have sinned against us. Then where is your forgiveness? I shall pray for you, Albert. I shall not let you forget that you are one of us. This is a curse.
Amen!
I can be helpful. I had heard that Goody Paris has... Well, I thought it would be better if you had only the writing of your sermons laboring your mind, not housewifery that I could help with. Do you mind if I came from time to time?
No. No, Lizzie, you are welcome here. There has been a loneliness in this house I have not known before. Where is it?
Over there. Here.
Another dead one here.
Dad!
Now there is room for the new ones.
Here's another witch.
No!
Oh, God, not a child.
Dorcas!
Leave me!
What is she doing here?
Get back, witch. It is your own fault.
How?
You sent her to afflict the girls, to avenge herself. They testified to it.
They lied?
She confessed, and she's got Satan's mark. Show her.
Satan sucked blood from me.
Tis a flea bite! The child is 5 years old! She's 5 years old!
Your prayers curse me. Your prayers curse me out. I shall not sign your book. I shall not sign your book.
I've been like this for 3 days.
No! No! Go! 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 No! No! Please! Don't take me! I'm not alone!
Who is it?
You're not alone!
Who is it? Afflicts you.
Goody knows. I do not want your prayers.
And do you know what
Goody
you are saying?
Knows.
Do you know?
I do not want your prayers. Goody
knows.
No.
Speak.
No.
Speak it.
No. Do not take me. No. Goody knows. I see you. Goody knows. I see you.
Oh, no.
Yes. I see you.
Oh, no.
Calm yourself,
no.
Child. Calm yourself.
No. Goody knows.
Calm yourself.
No.
You must get dressed, Mother.
Oh, Israel, how good of you to visit me. You heard I was feeling poorly.
The afflicted have cried out against another.
Those poor girls.
Mother, they have...
They have cried out against you. Ham shall not come to you, Rebecca. We will not let it.
Dungeon. 11 have hanged.
They are witches. Just what they deserve.
They have afflicted the girls.
Face lies! The girls themselves who should be added to the whipping post. I'll not be intimidated by the slander of them. Not I.
The witches must die.
I am not witches.
Rebecca Nurse is not a witch.
How can you doubt that?
You know that. Don't you, Goody Walcott? Both of you sit near her in church. Is she not pious? And Goodman Turnbull. Goody Nurse gave aid to your wife throughout her final days. Is she a witch? No. Sign this petition.
I cannot.
We cannot let an innocent woman suffer.
Goody Walcott.
It is too dangerous.
It is not safe.
It is too dangerous not to. If Rebecca Nurse can be cried out against, what's to keep you from being next? Any of you, who will sign it?
I shall. My brother's family is too much in the center of this. I do not trust that.
Good lad. Father, may I sign it?
Well, at least I don't resemble a mirthless old matron.
My dear, I'd have stoned the poor artist myself if he had captured any mirthlessness at all.
The others have arrived, Governor.
Oh, very well, then.
It was actually the old matron part that most concerned.
Righteous friends! Come in, sit down, sit down, sit down. Make yourselves at home. I trust you had a pleasant journey. No unfortunate mishaps on the way. Gentlemen, make yourselves at home. Welcome to the city. I have been made aware of something.
Do you desire a less rigid chair, Reverend? Or perhaps you'd prefer to stand?
Oh, kindly carry on, Governor. We've travelled all day in order to hear your concern.
This concerns me. It is a petition signed by, among many others, John Proctor and Israel Porter. Educate me as to this strange ferment of dissatisfaction that is growing in Salem.
We know of this petition. It was.
No, I would prefer to hear this from Reverend Stockton. Reverend, how goes it in Salem Village?
Well, Israel Porter and John Proctor are the leading members of a group of dissenters, you see, in the village.
Dissenters? But I understand these are among the most prominent families in Salem.
Yes, but they place their own interests before those of God's community.
Modern thinkers, perhaps.
Or failed Puritans, perhaps.
Then shed your light on the case of Rebecca Nurse.
39 have signed this petition in support of her. She's a woman of impeccable reputation. Yet you have seen fit to examine her for witchcraft and place her in prison.
With your permission, Governor, there is much evidence against her. We are all aggrieved by it as well. But her specter has tormented many innocents. I myself have seen the bruises and the pinpricks in the arms of the children.
We see it as a sign of the devil's advancement in our village. It is a sign that no one is safe.
Oh, is it a sign of that?
Do you doubt spectral evidence?
Of course not. But I must forbid the hanging of any more persons unless there is proof that corroborates the spectral evidence. You must either get a confession or physical evidence as well. Understood?
Are you afraid of touching a witch?
Yes.
morning, Goody Nurse. I must ask you to disrobe.
I shall not.
You're to be examined for witches' teats and devil's marks.
'Tis not necessary. On my honor, as a Christian, you will find none. Reverend Paris, surely you can stop this humiliation. Tell them how many years I have been a devoted member of the church.
You would better your chances, good wife nurse, if you would allow the magistrates to determine the truth for themselves.
Pray don't make me disrobe in front of them.
Rebecca nurse, you are on trial for the felony of practicing witchcraft. Would you kindly do as the court requests? The midwives may proceed with the examination.
There is a teat. The devil suckles there.
That is not a witch's mark. It more resembles a mole.
No, it is a teat.
For the record of the deposition, make note of the divergence of opinion, but also make note of the fact that the witness did not cry, which is compatible with the witch's inability to shed tears. You may examine the pudendum.
Spread your legs. Show me tenderness and I shall find God, dear. Show me mercy and I shall find God, dear. Show me reason and I shall find God there.
Goody nurse, it is not a Puritan prayer.
No, it is a prayer of my own.
This is blasphemy. God will strike you.
No, child. It is people who punish, not God. God is that which finds forgiveness and understanding when others cannot. I can see that now.
Show me a bar of good lye soap and I shall find God there.
Yes. Even in that small thing, soap, there is God there. God is everywhere. God is all around us. God is within us. God is within us.
Show me laughter, and I shall find God there.
Show me a jug of rum. And I shall find God there. Show me a key. Yes, a key, and I shall find God there.
Show me a chamber pot.
A chamber pot, and I shall find God there. Show me hope. And I shall find God there.
Mary Lacey, we have brought you here from prison this day in order to help you save your soul. Now, tell us about your work with the devil.
I stole what he asked me.
Once again, in meticulous detail.
He came to me. The devil. As a blackbird.
Did you not say the bird was yellow?
Oh, yes, yellow. It was yellow.
Yes. And?
And, he said he would tear me to pieces if I did not sign his book and serve him. I had no choice. And after, I had the devil's gift of being able to afflict people.
And who else? Who else rides with you? Mary Lacey, give me the names of all the witches and wizards that you know. Don't be afraid. These are our enemies, and they wish us harm.
John Proctor. Tis John Proctor. He means us harm.
John Proctor. John Proctor. John Proctor. John Proctor. John Proctor.
Maybe I have seen Goodman Proctor.
And he rides with you?
He?
John Proctor.
He?
John Proctor.
Yes, yes.
I was praying for you.
For me?
You are in the room with a confessed witch. I was praying that the devil does not touch you.
Thank you.
Although, the power of your goodness certainly overshadows the feebleness of my prayers.
You have faith in me, don't you?
As I do in our God.
John Proctor, I have come to arrest you for the crimes of witchcraft. You must present yourself.
I shall not.
Where is your wife?
My wife, by the grace of God, she's done nothing.
You are under arrest.
They shall not accuse her when it is me they wish to hurt. Take me and leave her be.
John!
Get inside, woman!
But Proctor, you are under
arrest. Do not touch my wife! She is with child!
Take them both!
She is with child! We have legs! We can walk by ourselves!
What are you doing?
Get me!
Get off me!
Do not hurt the children! John, they're taking everything!
We are confiscating your belongings to pay for your jail term!
How dare you!
Father!
Lies! Absurd lies, all of it!
Can you not see how they suffer? Your spectre torments you! I shall prove to you that they are not lying. By this test, we shall know the truth.
Any putty, child, rise up. Come along. Meet your tormentor. Come towards him. Touch him.
No. No, I cannot.
Be not afraid.
I cannot.
And
he shall kill me,
are in
and
the
he
house
shall strangle
God.
Me, and yes, he shall.
He shall not.
No.
I shall show ye.
No!
The Lord is with me, Annie.
No!
Rest assured.
No.
Witness the power of God all around.
Annie, if indeed you are tormented by his spectre, lay your hand upon him, and that will rid you of his evil.
Cast your dove aside. God is with you. See?
John Proctor. You are guilty of causing great harm.
Aye, aye. Away with you.
This is pure madness.
I have harmed no one.
Yes, and you have committed sundry acts of witchcraft.
No! On the body. This man is on trial because of his opposition to that family.
Silence!
You cannot silence me. You can hang me until I am cold, but you will not silence the truth of my words.
You are convicted of witchcraft and condemned to die by hanging from the neck.
No!
Until you are dead.
No!
Come, let us leave.
Father! Joseph, no! No!
Is that your confession?
If you take my life away, God will give you blood for drink.
John Proctor, I will give you one final opportunity to confess your crimes.
I can only confess an act I have not done, nor proclaim my innocence. There's naught you wish to hear from me, but the accusations that ring in your own head. I shall admit only that I am not ready to die. Mary, tell Elizabeth. This will not take me from her and the children. Tell her to believe that.
Good man, Proctor!
We shall pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Let thy kingdom come. Thy will.
Samuel Parris, only God can give and only God can take away. Yet, upon this hour, I shall end my days because you have taken God's role upon yourself. But do not imagine my last thoughts to be rancorous against you. They're not. I know you'll have your own God to answer to one day. Instead, I shall pray that we stand before you today for the last innocent blood to be spilled upon this earth.
Hangman,
do not hesitate. He is guilty. Do you not see the evil specter behind his shoulder whispering in his ear? Do it! Do it!
Rebecca Nurse, you have been excommunicated. Your only chance at salvation is through confession. Until then, there is no God for you to pray to. And therefore, you are condemned for eternity in hell! Do you understand?
No! She is innocent! This is wrong! No! You shall not murder my mother! You shall not murder my mother! No!
Save your breath, Rebecca Nurse. You pray for Satan.
Let her finish.
Yes! Let her finish!
Let her finish!
Yes, let her pray.
Please, sir. I beg of you, she cannot be a witch. She has made no mistake. Tis I who made the mistake, sir. Tis I who made the mistake, sir. She is innocent, sir. Please. No! Who will forgive us? Who will forgive us?
Hear my remorse. Tis a horrible sin. Tis true. Tis true.
Enough, Anne.
Tis true, tis true. Tis I who should be hanging from that tree.
Mama? You're frightening them.
They should be frightened. What have we done? An innocent woman died today because of me. And you.
Man, stop it.
A man died.
Because he opposed you. Opposing you is not a crime before God.
Do you know what you are saying?
This village is being cleansed of your enemies. Israel Porter was right.
Ban!
Do you deny it?
Stop it!
I will stop it! And if it means I hang for it, I will stop this. I shall speak out.
You shall speak out. Ban, hear me. You speak out now. You are not the only one who will hang.
You should rest now. You can't stay long.
I have been mistaken, good father. It is not possible that this being is of sin. She's perfect. She's not but innocence embodied. She is radiant. I fear that Reverend Ferris is wrong in what he has told.
Do not speak such words.
Do you believe the Reverend Goody Potter that we are all born guilty?
Do not ask me.
Do you?
Yes, I believe it.
Look at her. How could she believe that she's not innocent?
Because they grow into us.
Goody Putnam, please. I can no longer believe. Won't you look at her, Goody Putnam? Please. See it. Whatever we grow into, whatever mistakes we make, we still have this inside of us. I see that now.
I heard she is here. Is she?
Yes. And you have a child, Joseph.
Where is she?
Joseph. You must beware.
Why? What happened to her?
Not for Lizzie, for yourself. I fear you shall be cried out against.
Are you threatening me?
No. I'm trying to save you. Take them now and go before your brother returns home.
You may touch her. Both of us.
I am taking you home now.
Yes, home.
Yes, the girls have identified 60 witches in Andover alone. And in Topsfield, well, the reverend there has asked for the girls to be sent up as soon as they are able. We are literally surrounded by witches. It's a full-scale war against Puritanism, but it is a war which we are winning. And I think we owe a debt of gratitude to the Reverend Parris here. The work he has done here in Salem Village, we would not be where we are but for that.
Elizabeth Putnam.
Watch over her for me.
Visitor. Lizzie. You're not afeard. I've come to help you.
You could not.
I can. Confess. If you do, your life will be spared, at least for some time. Confess to what is asked of you.
You have faith in my innocence.
So I am risking all of me to save you.
And what of the others down here with me? What of my husband? My child?
Your husband is a warlock. They are witches. Your child, if you...
We are all equally innocent. Guilty of nothing more than being human. Where is your God now?
Our God, Lizzie. Do not lose faith. Or in me.
Your faith, Reverend Parris, seems too much aligned with your self-interest. Yet self-interest is the very evil you preach against. We are all damned in this place because of you. Yet we were more damned when we sat before you in your meeting house, laying our trust at your feet. I would rather stay down here, even if it means my death, then be with you and your God up there.
Lizzie.
him take my children! Do not let him take my children!
It's a crisis as it was before.
It's worse, I fear.
Governor, the afflicted girls of Salem Village have cried out again. We receive this.
It should be directed to the Reverend Stoughton.
Sir, you should look at it.
I believe your work is finished here now, Reverend.
The work of God is never finished, sir, with your permission.
We shall see. Know ye this woman beside me? She is my wife, Lady Mary Phipps.
You have called her a servant of Satan.
Which of you called out her name first?
Which of you? I know your afflictions, that you go mute and sightless at will, but you shall not be silent now!
Which of you first cried out her name?
'Twas I who called her name.
Have you ever laid eyes on my wife before?
No, sir.
And now that you regard her, does she resemble a witch?
She seems as much a witch as the others were.
Now, Reverend, tell me. Does my wife resemble a witch in your eyes?
Perhaps in this case we have been deluded by Satan.
Deluded by Satan? And is that how you shall have time to remember this sorry episode? No! I believe you were deluded by your own fears and weaknesses and had the arrogance to call this feeble human delusion, God's will.
Did you say arrogance, sir?
Yes, arrogance.
May I remind you?
Where was your heart?
In your search for godliness and faith. Did you not even once
press yourselves to heed, if not logic, then simple humanity? How could decent men and women followed this shrill, self-righteous call of the falsely powerful and become deaf to the simple voices of their own heart?
Thank you.
did this happen here? How did this happen here?